Most teenagers' teeth shift after they get their braces off because they don't wear their retainers. This teenager's teeth moved because of a tumor. And the crazier part, this tumor wasn't even in her mouth. Check out the workup and treatment today on The Open Reduction. Welcome to The Open Reduction, your channel, everything oral and maxillofacial surgery. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten, and today we're going to be reviewing a pathology case. This patient is a 16-year-old female who completed orthodontic treatment 1 year ago. She's been wearing her retainers, but recently she's noticed that her teeth are starting to shift. She's had no pain, but she feels like her top jaw is swollen. She returned to her orthodontist who took a radiograph, and this is what it showed. We can see a unilocular radiolucent lesion in the anterior maxilla between the right canine and lateral incisor. It's causing bony expansion and displacement of the tooth roots. Okay, so we have a 16-year-old female with a unilocular expansile lesion in the right maxilla causing tooth displacement. So what's the differential diagnosis? First, is this lesion benign or malignant? Malignant lesions look very aggressive on radiographic assessment. Key findings include ill-defined margins or borders, cortical destruction, and soft tissue extension. This lesion has very well-defined borders with cortical expansion but not destruction. Therefore, I'm thinking this is a benign lesion. However, this lesion is locally aggressive. She has been under regular care at her orthodontist's office, and 1 year ago, this lesion did not exist on the radiograph. In addition, it is causing tooth root displacement, which is a sign of a more serious benign lesion. The differential for a locally aggressive radiolucent lesion includes an odontogenic keratocyst, ameloblastoma, central giant cell granuloma, odontogenic myxoma, or an interosseous venous malformation. I anesthetized the patient, aspirated it to make sure there was no blood in the lumen, then I enucleated it and sent it off to the pathologist. This lesion turned out to be, wait for it, a central giant cell granuloma. Oh! Okay, now that we have the diagnosis, what's the next step? Do we A, monitor with radiographs at regular intervals to ensure the lesion does not recur? B, order additional testing? Or C, plan a surgical resection of the surrounding bone with extraction of the adjacent teeth to obtain clear margins? If you said B, you're correct. A patient with a central giant cell granuloma requires additional blood testing. Next question, what lab value do we want to measure? Is it A, the estrogen level, B, the cortisol level, C, T3, T4 thyroid hormones, D, the parathyroid hormone, or E, human growth hormone, or HGH? While you're thinking about it, please take a moment to subscribe to my channel, The Open Reduction. The channel covers a wide range of topics on everything oral and maxillofacial surgery. By clicking the subscribe button, you're letting me know that you're benefiting from the content, and you're also helping the content reach more people. So back to the question at hand, what lab value do we want to check on a patient with a central giant cell granuloma? If you said D, you're correct. These lesions can be the result of elevated parathyroid hormone levels. The parathyroid gland controls systemic calcium and phosphate levels, and when there is excessive hormone production, patients can develop brown tumors or central giant cell granulomas from high parathyroid levels. I ordered a PTH level on this patient and it was very high. She had a full workup and it was discovered that she had a parathyroid adenoma or a tumor of the parathyroid gland causing excessive parathyroid hormone levels. The tumor was removed, her hormone levels returned to normal, and the lesion in the maxilla resolved. Thanks so much for watching. Please drop any questions you have in the comments section. Click that like button. I'm Dr. Tom Bolten. I'll catch you next time on The Open Reduction.